didn't want his youngest son to go with him, as he was afraid something may happen to him.
Benjamin, my youngest son, don't go. Please don't go. Stay here with me. Watch the Olympics on TV. Oh, what goals have Britain's got? We're doing really well. Don't go. Please don't go.
There are three reasons why I
shouldn't. One, I'm your father. Two, I'm your father. And three, if you go, it'll spoil the whole story.
Right. If I don't go, I want a fiver, I want a TV in my room.
A fiver and a TV in your room?
Yeah.
Good grief, he's a brilliant Jew, isn't he? Okay. Need one. TV and £2.50, yeah?
No.
£2.51. Done.
Right.
You have
to. Wrong story. Your name's not Jack.
Joseph was governor of Egypt and was selling corn to the people all over the world.
Here's the corn. Look at this lovely bunch of corn.
Oh, I've got a lovely magic potion. Big one, small one, little one.
Joseph's brothers came to buy some corn, but although he recognised his brothers, they didn't recognise him. He asked, "Where have you come from?" They answered, "We have come from Canaan to buy food." Joseph remembered his dreams about him and said,
"You are spies."
Oh, no, no we're not.
Oh, yes, you are.
Oh, no, we're not.
Oh, yes, you
are. No, sir, they answered, "We have come as slaves to buy food. We are all brothers. We are not spies. We are honest men. We are 12 brothers in all, sons of the same man. One brother is dead and the youngest is now with our father." Joseph replied, "You are spies. This is how you will be tested. I swear by the name of the king that you will never leave unless your youngest brother comes here. One of you must go and get him. The rest of you will be kept here under guard until the truth of what you say can be tested." He put them into prison for 3 days.
Go on, get in there! Go on! Hang them! Don't let them lick it! Don't let them me! Sheik! Hungry?
Yeah.
Tough.
Now, can you take the poor
girl? Oh! Incompetent.
On the third day, Joseph said to them, "I am a God-fearing man, and I will spare your lives on one condition. To prove that you are honest men, one of you will stay in prison where you've been kept. The rest of you may go back to your starving families with the corn you have bought." They had to bring their youngest brother back to Joseph to prove that they were telling the truth and they wouldn't be put to death. They agreed to this and said to one another, "Yes, now we are suffering."
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, you don't know what suffering
whoa.
Is.
Whoa! Whoa! Three times! Whoa!
Reuben said, "I told you not to harm the boy, but you would not listen, and now we are being paid back for his death." Joseph understood what they had said, but they didn't know it. Joseph left them and began to cry. When he was able to speak again, he came back, picked out Simeon.
Who's Simeon?
She.
He.
up in front of them.
I'm in it. I'm in there.
Are you okay?
Shy a yellow ribbon round the old oak tree. There've been three long days. You still want me?
Joseph gave orders to fill his brother's sacks with corn and to put each man's money back into his sack. The brothers loaded their donkeys with the corn they had brought and left. Where's the donkey?
Oh, it's all right, it's having a drink. Come on, Nettie.
Wow, that's a smart looking ass.
Come on then, get on yours.
Have you filled your stock? Not yet.
Fill your stocks then, everyone.
Here's your stock.
I said stock, not stock. They found a place to stay overnight, and one of the brothers opened his sack to feed his donkey and found money at the top of the sack. My money has been returned to me.
Money, in a rich man's world.
When the brothers arrived back, they told their father, Jacob, all about what had happened to them. Jacob said, "Do you want me to lose all my children? Have you gone back yet?"
Yes.
Right, come on.
Joseph is gone, Simeon is gone, and now you want to take away Benjamin. I am the one who suffers.
Don't take it away from me!
Stop! Stop! Max!
He's upset yet?
Reuben said to his father, "If I do not bring Benjamin back to you, you can take and kill my two sons. Put him in my care and I will bring him back." Jacob didn't want Benjamin to go. If he lost Benjamin, the sorrow would kill. The famine came and got worse, and when Jacob's family had eaten all the corn, Jacob said, "Go back and buy a little food for us." The brothers reminded Jacob that they must return with Benjamin. Jacob said, "Why did you have to tell this man you have another brother?" They answered, "He has so many questions about our family." He asked if our father was still alive. We had to answer him.
How many brothers have you got? Did you work to Coronation Street last night? Have you still got noisy neighbours?
Yeah.
Has the donkey still got stomachache?
Yeah.
Too many questions.
Judith said to his father, "Send the boy with me, we will leave at once. Then none of us will starve to death. I will pledge my life and you can hold me responsible for him." Jacob told his sons to take gifts of honey, spice, nuts and money, and told them to give the money back that they had found in their sacks.
Right, come here, son, I'll get some stuff, stick with you.
Okay, Dad.
Ain't like what? Cowboy, you scruffy lot, ain't like. Right, egg sandwich.
Egg sandwich.
Egg sandwich.
Egg sandwich. Thanks, Blair.
Half a coconut.
Right, okay. Let's stir it now. Spice!
Oh, you've got enough spice in your life, Dad.
Look at Cheeky.
Look how many sons you got!
You're too young to that sort of thing, you are.
Look, Dad. Look.
You need my nuts,
Andrew. What's happening today? Youngsters are very cheeky. What are teachers in school to know? Honey!
Honey!
Honey.
Don't call me, honey.
Shock, horror,
what? The brothers tore their clothes in sorrow. And the other brothers would have to return to their father without him.
Oh, no!
Judah pleaded with Joseph, if we go back without our youngest brother, our father will die.
Joseph is still alive.
They told him.
Just
hold me up.
Why?
Now, Joseph! Come on, Dad!
Good eye!
Try to move!
It's alive, it's alive!
It's alive! Joseph! Oh, I'm alive! Oh, I'm alive!
There!
Oh, come on!
Boundary!
Remember in the Bible. I don't remember those ghosts coming into the prison. Anyway, if you're not sure, go and read it up again. There's only 13 chapters in Genesis to read on. But we've got a wonderful stardom here, and may I just let you all know that they are performing at the London Palladium. They are performing from season from September the 1st. September 2nd. And we have a bevy of talent here, including musical, speech talent, singing talent, but we know we need a replacement for Frank Sinatra. But I'm afraid, I'm sorry to say, that John Holmes has not got the...
I didn't buy one.
I might say that we have tried to provide the props and the costumes, but if any ladies have lost two large bras, do not apply the big ones.
They're
mad! Do not take the Guardian next week because the photographer came along at a very difficult moment. Ron has been very much in the news. Well, if they produce that photograph, I'm not coming back from my holiday. And you'll see our ever-vigilant cook and the character of the...